Hi guys, welcome back to my channel for Final Fantasy Brave Exvius video. And this is Dark Vision 15 and the final area, the magical stage, the magical domain of fire and darkness. And this is the second fight where we must fight this dark wing dragon. And the weakness is fire and dark, but this attack is water and lightning. It seems Gumi change the elemental attack here, so I make some adjustments. I already set up it before, but I also make some adjustment here. So from my experience, the lightning elemental attack is the magical attack, so the water is the physical attack. So I will buff it using realm for lightning elemental resistance using bar Tandaga from Carbuncle. And then bar water ga from Leviathan, this one. So make sure all your party is above 20% of water elemental resistance. We don't care about the lightning because I will tank it using snow, because solitary pattern snow can cover our team using this cover magic. So let's start for the elemental resistance, normal form above 20% of water. Let's check for Terra, for Realm, Luis, and then Aerith. For lightning is fine because snow will tank it, and snow. So let's take a look for the equipment here. For Ibarra, on normal form is naked, only some. I don't need the 10,000 needle here. So for Ibarra brave shift form is for the Kilton on turn 4. I won't make a long video for this. I'm using Starlight Elena vision card here, and lots of dragon killer, and also don't forget to equip rod here, just because I will do the rod imperil from realm. So let's take a look for Ibarra max out through dual magic, 235% of LB damage boost, and for dragon 125% of magical dragon killer. And the stats is good. And for Terra, this is her setup on normal form, on brave shift form, using this Levantine. We only can craft one, this Levantine upgrade into plus 4. This will give us 50% of LB damage boost. And don't forget this Minister Code also upgrade, getting upgrade when when Shantotto comes, not Shantotto but Arpaul from Final Fantasy 11. So this is my Terra setup, and my Terra has 200% of total magic, 220% of expert damage, 300% of evo damage and LB damage boost. So some people comment on my video that he need a killer on the evoker, but we don't need any killer for evoker, so it doesn't matter for evoker. So next for realm, 100% provoke and evasion as usual, using crimson butterfly and lock dagger, and this Rinora conductor uniform, the highest HP. And that's all for realm's job, for feeling LB, and then rod imperil, and this one LB feel for Aerith. For Luis, normal form for getting LB, and I forgot to only equip this annual arrangement string, but we don't need this unless you use this is my Luis setup on normal form. On the brave chief form is the kill turn. Since Luis can do the gun imperil, it's fine to using gun here. So my Luis has max out through dual wield magic, and don't forget for Luis is using the physical killer, 275% of physical dragon killer, and 250% of LB damage boost. So for Luis, for this type of LB, is the physical attack using magic damage. The target parameter is magic, so this will attack enemy spirit, and Luis can also break, can do 90% spirit break. So for Aerith on normal form, gear up for the LB feel, and don't forget to equip this one. This here ada, I must recover HP from realm. I need to do twice LB from Aerith on the level 35. We need 65 LB here. So Brave Shift form is the kill. We use it on the kill turn on this, and also the second turn. Alright, for Aerith, Rod of Bahamut, this will give 75% of magical dragon killer. I think it's good. And Aerith will do the LB here, since her LB is the tech chain, only 15 hit. And my Aerith has, for dragon killer, 150% of magical dragon killer and 250% of LB damage boost. So that's all for Aerith. Oh, I forgot to mention, you can craft this Aerith STMR. I think it's good to use your STMR Mogul, because if you got the second Aerith, you can use the Mogul, use the after you awaken into EX plus 2, there is a STMR Mogul on your mail. So STMR Mogul on your mail, you can use it on your dupe or second Cetra Descendant Aerith. So that's all for my tips. I think it's fine to use a Mogul. Next, for Snow, Solitary Petal Snow, he can shine on this battle because of the darkness weakness, darkness elemental weakness. So this is my setup, the highest spirit. Yep. Lots of killer in this for Snow, using the physical killer here. For Snow, 250% of physical dragon killer and 280% of LB damage boost. So I think that's all for my team, and let's go to the fight. Sorry for long introduction. I always give the detail of my party. Alright guys, let's go to the fight here. Alright, let's for Ibarra, let's start with unlocking her quad cast. Do you think this debilitating error? And then for Terra, using the unlock magic here for unlock the quad cast. And for Realm will do the Bartandaga for lightning elemental resistance. And then for Aerith, let's use Bar Waterga for water elemental resistance. So our party is above 100% of water. I think it's fine for tanking the magical attack. So for now, Luis, let's use this one, triple quad cast of Ionic Fire Blaster. This will give our party 5 to 10 LB CRISPR cast. I need it for Aerith. Hope we can fill it. Yes, Aerith already full, I think. So let's use Snow, double cast stout, cover magic here, and this tap of this pair. This will imbue Snow with dark, and also 15% amplify to himself. Oh, I forgot to mention that it costs 25% of Snow LB, Snow HP, I mean. And we already negate it all. And on second turn, we need to cap for the chain score. Let's use Ibara Spellbinding. This Kaminari. 4 times, so for Terra, I'm using Quadruple Magitek, Blizzara. And for Realm, let's use Triple Black Magic, since Realm can do Triple Black Magic by default. So for Luis, let's use Quad Core, another Ionic Fire Blaster. Now since Erit LB already full, let's use Erit. No. I need the on Erit Brave Shift form. This will not imbue holy to our team. So let's use this tech chain. Let's use this 4 first and then the tech chain. 1, 2, 3, 4. The tech chain. I need it some from Luis. This will bypass the threshold from the enemy. As you can see, 68%. I think it's fine. The enemy threshold attack only dispel. So let's now use snow ATB charge. This LTB charge will give will fill snow LB. Aqua Shot, Hell Thunder. Here comes the dispel. Dispel only goes to Realm. I think that's fine. So for Ibara, let's set up for the kill turn on turn 4. So Ibara need to Brave Shift and then use the Weakening. Yes, this one. Weakening Apeol. This 120% of Darkness Elemental Imperil. Our team already have 400% of attack, defense, magic, and spirit buff from Erit. Now for Terra, Brave Shiver. As usual, triple Magitek, Transburst, Magitek Power Release, Power Release Fire, and then Magitek Barrier. For Luis, let's use Quad Core. Ionic Fire Blaster first. This will give some of LB Crisp for Erit. This one, the Magnus ability. This will imperil the enemy 135% and 90% of Spirit Break. And then this Fire Starter. This is the Fire Imbue for herself is 3 turn, but for our party is only for the current turn. Only 1 turn is means the current turn. And also give the area effect of 25% amplify to fire elemental. And the other one is the killer. So this one is, I think this is the killer. Yes, dragon killer. So I need to fill Erit. Erit LB. Let's use Realm here. Double sketch. These two, you are still standing. 30 LB fill and this one, Road Imperil. So make sure your Realm HP is above 8000 HP. 35% Road Imperil. So Erit LB is not full enough. I think it's fine. So let's use. For this one, the AoE imbue for our team, and also 30% of fire amplify to our team. This one, and then for snow, let's do another ATB charge. This ATB charge will give us 200%. Will give snow 200% of LB damage boost. think it's not important because Erit already buff our party 250%. Alright, this is the kill turn. That's the Imperial Scum. So the Imperial Scum in the end of turn 3, 6, 9. So for Erit ALB here, for the level 40 needs 60, but on my current level 35 needs 65 ALB. This will boost our party 400% and also ALB damage boost for 250%. So Erit LB is LB, as you can see, is not full enough, so Realm can help her to fill and restore this using this one, Master Speed Scratch. Yes, Erit LB already full, and let's go for the kill turn. Ibarra LB, Terra LB, Chaotic Inferno, Louis change form, LB Psionic Pulsar Blast, and Erit LB for the Tech Chain and Snow LB. Alright, start with Terra first. These two, Tech Chain, and then Snow. Come on. See how much damage we can deal. 11.5 billion. This is my first time clear for the perfect score on the mage or the magical stage. So let's see the damage here. The biggest damage comes from Terra, and then Louis, Erit, and Snow. As you can see, Snow is the second rank of this damage. So that's all for my tips for using Snow. I think Snow is good. So the physical is Louis and Snow. The magical is Ibarra. And then the hybrid, this is the evoke damage. So I think that's all for my tips for finishing this second fight of Dark Vision 15 on the area 5. So this is the final the final enemy, a beast revived from darkness where we must fight Ifrit. This is the beast type enemy, and the enemy attack is, they didn't mention it. So I think that's all for my today's video. Hope you can enjoy this video, and thank you guys for watching. If you have any question, please comment on the down below. And if you like my content, feel free to support me by subscribing my channel and share to your friend if your friend is struggle finishing this Dark Vision. So I think that's all. I'm David from FFBE Indonesia. Bye bye.